Hi there! Welcome to Ash Canyon Bird Sanctuary. I'm Sherry Williamson. Behind the camera is Tom Wood. We're with the Southeastern Arizona Bird Observatory. Hopefully you have already learned that the Southeastern Arizona Bird Observatory, thanks to an extremely generous donation from a donor in California, acquired Ash Canyon Bird Sanctuary, the former home of the late Mary Jo Ballator, last fall. And we have been working very, very hard through the winter and spring to try to bring it back up to the beautiful sanctuary and oasis that Mary Jo built with pollinator plants. And thankfully, we've had a tremendous amount of help from many of Mary Jo's friends, including Tony Batiste, who is one of her closest friends and who made the donation to acquire her property possible, as well as many volunteers, including volunteers from the Sierra Vista Area Gardeners Club, helping us bring her gardens back from unfortunately a very neglected state subsequent to her passing. We also have a number of other improvements, and we're continuing on to make more and more improvements in the site. And we're looking forward to having the public be able to come back. Right now we're closed because of the COVID-19 pandemic, but we're anxiously awaiting the time when the danger has passed and we're able to invite the public back to enjoy this beautiful sanctuary. Mary Jo's spirit's still here with us, and we know she would love to have people here, but we're going to give you a vicarious visit to Ash Canyon Bird Sanctuary with a little bit of a video walk around. I have to pardon the landscaping materials all piled up here. We're obviously doing lots of garden work, but among the improvements that we've added are new signage and a donation box, and we have a sightings board that we're keeping updated. Even though we don't have a lot of human visitors, we're trying to keep the sightings board updated with the birds that are coming in. Migration is in full swing right now. It's late April and the birds are coming in fast and furious. And even though we don't have a whole lot of hummingbird activity at the feeders, we do have lots and lots of birds coming by. You see the Mexican jays flying by in the background, perhaps. So this will be something that folks, this will be the first stop that folks can make when they come in to the sanctuary once we're able to invite visitors back, and stop in, see what's being seen, and have an idea of what to expect. You can see the gardens are starting to look quite nice. Some of the plants that Mary Jo planted did not survive last year's drought and neglect during the time between her passing and the time we acquired the property. However, with lots of tender loving care from our volunteers, including Lynn Yarbrough over there, who's watering one of the flower beds, and also Christy Reske, who's one of our live-in volunteer caretakers here, the plants are starting to come back from a very stressed out state. We're going to be replacing a lot of the plants that just didn't make it through the winter. And we've already done some major renovations here, including this beautiful rock border that Lynn is largely responsible for.
And the path.
The path is part of a major garden renovation made possible by a very generous donation from a donor in Pennsylvania. We heard from this donor following an interview that I did with the American Birding Association on their American Birding podcast, talking about the acquisition of Ash Canyon Bird Sanctuary and our plans for the site, including plans to make the site even more valuable to a broader range of pollinators. And she was very, very excited about the improvements. She made an extremely generous donation of $25,000 that has allowed us to buy garden amendments and resurface the paths, renovate the irrigation system, create a rainwater harvesting system, which you're about to see. This is one of my favorite colored salvias right here, this intense purple. I don't know how well that's going to come through on video, but this is just an intense, eye-searing shade of magenta purple, and one of my favorite colors in this whole garden. A lot of these plants will be propagating so that we can replace plants as they die, but also so that we can share some of the plants with people who may be starting their own hummingbird gardens. The plants are starting to look really nice now. The native peritenstemon, these tall wands of lovely hot pink blooms, are looking really, really good right now. This is their main bloom season, and the hummingbirds are all over them, but unfortunately a lot of them are not right here on the property, so a lot of the hummingbirds are off exploring the huge patches of native penstemons in the surrounding landscape. One of the major renovations that we did, again with a tremendous amount of just backbreaking labor from volunteers with the Sierra Vista Area Gardeners Club, is what we call the Lucifer bed. This is a little desert flower bed that was in pretty bad shape. A lot of the plants were dead. The gophers had eaten a lot of them. It was pretty much a mess. The irrigation system was in a disarray. And with a couple of days of really hard work by the Sierra Vista Area Gardeners Club volunteers, we were able to get the dead material out, weed the bed, get the invasive exotic plants out of this bed, and create a space where we could then plant natives and pollinator-friendly plants in here, ones that will not try to take over the landscape like some of the ones that were in here before. We're just now starting to see some of the regrowth of some of the plants from the winter, but we've already added a number of plants to the site that will hopefully continue to thrive and bloom through the years if we can keep the gophers at bay. We've got Chuparosa, which is a favorite of the Lucifer hummingbirds. This little unpromising looking sprig that has a few little green leaves at the tip is Chuparosa, Justicia Californica, that the Lucifer hummingbirds really, really love. We've got Gooding Verbena, or one of our native verbenas. It's a very common plant along the roadside that the little butterflies just love. More Gooding Verbena. We have the old Chuparosa that we were just about ready to pull out of the ground, only to discover new growth on it. So it is coming back from the dead like a phoenix. It's rising from the ashes. And we've also had some plants donated, including some little penstemons that just went in the ground over on the other side of the bed, a couple of beautiful calandras, fairy dusters. These are Baja fairy duster. They're not our local fairy duster. They're a little more cold sensitive than our local fairy duster, but they're much prettier. Hopefully we can keep them alive through the winters as the time goes on. The old photo blind is going to get some renovation, but we have a new photo blind that's already built by Tony Batiste. Tony is taking over creating and renovating and restoring the photo blind setup. So hopefully we'll be able to be inviting photographers back to the sanctuary soon. That's something we can do with some social distancing. So photographers maybe come on the first, folks that we invite back to the sanctuary. So much new growth. We have little buds coming in on the ocotillos. These are eventually going to be bright scarlet flowers that the hummingbirds are going to enjoy. Another one of the major projects in cooperation with our neighbor Karen LeMay of Pollinator Corridor Southwest. This doesn't look like much right now, but you should have seen it before. Again, with help from the volunteers from the Sierra Vista Area Gardeners Club, we removed pounds and pounds and pounds and pounds of non-native invasive grasses and created space for native pollinator plants. We have acquired the first few pollinator plants for that garden and already have them in and are tending them, but we're going to be adding to this site as it goes on, and hopefully it'll be highly valuable for our beautiful native butterflies and bees and we have a beautiful dark buckeye, or smoky buckeye, going by, so it is valuable to pollinators.
We'll come back to the other feeding area here in a bit. We'll do another quick tour of the garden. You can see the first of our rainwater harvesting barrels on this side. The big barrels are around back, which you'll see in just a little bit. Just do a quick walk around it again. For those that know and love this place, you can see what we've done, trying to maintain the feel of Mary Jo's backyard.
Pathwork is still in progress. We need some more material brought in to level the main entrance path that comes down to the casita, which, when we can invite visitors back again, will be our visitor services area with a bathroom and beverages for sale or donation.
Yeah, this is kind of our volunteer center, and we've got all the bird seed in here. Spend about $11,000 a year on bird seed of various types, along with peanut butter mix, Mary Jo's special peanut butter mix, and
sugar,
jelly, and sugar, and all that.
Have to keep the birds in the style to which they become accustomed. Here's Tim Blount, is our
living caretaker. Takes good care of the place.
Yeah, puts in a tremendous amount of work just keeping these birds well fed.
Back here we have two massive 2,500 gallon rainwater harvesting tanks that will allow us to irrigate with rainwater for much of the year. We're still just finishing that up. And
we
then
haven't had enough rain since the barrels went in to fill them up, but hopefully the first few monsoon rains will fill it all up.
Tony has put in a brand new photo blind back here. And having a photographer design the blind is really helpful because we've got he knows enough that we've got the props up front and the background is far enough away that it will be blurred and not cause any interference with the photographs. I think this is going to be a real popular spot. So, for many of you, this is a familiar sight, and my goal this morning is to see if we can get 20 species of birds here in a usable amount of video. Just going to pan around the feeders here for a minute, and then we'll go back and start IDing birds. All right, we'll start off with the ubiquitous oriole coming to the oranges. Scots Oriole. We've got three species of orioles here right now.
We had what looked like a young male bullock's come by, but he was a little skittish, flew off.
It's bullock's oriole. Here comes a mourning dove strolling through the rush pile.
And a rock squirrel strolling through the brush pile too. White winged doves are coming in.
Full of white winged doves. Here's the white winged dove that we keep hearing doing that "Who Cooks for You" call. Male black-headed grosbeak. Acorn woodpecker.
Gila woodpecker helping himself to the hummingbird feeder. Rufous crowned sparrow. And a spotted towhee hanging around. Most of the sparrows are here in the wintertime and leave in the summer. We're working on an interpretive panel that will highlight Mary Jo's accomplishments here. For now, we just have this picture of her looking over our shoulders while we watch the birds. White-breasted nuthatches are nesting here by the porch. In a nest box Mary Jo had out for him. I think I've got a Virginia's warbler over here. This little bubbler is a favorite of the birds. It's our black-headed grosbeak again. Broad-billed hummingbird is back. Oh. Got a black-chinned hummingbird on feeder three here. Well, I didn't get my 20 species, but still a pretty good day here at Ash Canyon Bird Sanctuary. And we look forward to the time that we're able to host visitors again. This place is better when there are people enjoying all the birds that are here. And we look forward to that time.